Hi guys, welcome to Indie Game Hustle. In this UModeler video, we're going to take a look at the selection tools. All right, so the first thing we're going to do, if you want, you can go ahead and create two objects. I have a sphere and I have a cube. Once I select one of these objects, on the right side, you'll see a set of different tools that we can manipulate. All right, so the first thing I want to bring up is that each section here deals with a different tool type. All right, so the one we'll be talking about today is going to be the selection, but you also have the drawing, you have shapes. This one is going to be addition or adding. You have the remove, you have the tweak, you have the surface, and these are going to be, miscellaneous or different types of settings and things that we can do. Now, if you were to click these individual categories, you can actually minimize those sections so that we can just focus in on exactly what matters. So I'm going to go ahead and click on selection to show that. All right. So the first one in our list here is a all selection. So if I have something selected and I want to select both of these, you can actually click that and it'll select all. All right. Now, the same I believe that can be done is if I select one of the edges here and I select this, it's going to either select none, or if you hover, it says none selection tool. So it's changing it in a way based on the current situation. So currently there's nothing selected. All right. And then now there is something selected. All right. And this of course is while we're in the edge tool. So this applies to whether we're in the object mode or if we're deeper within the actual vertex or edge or faces, that sort of thing. So that's the all selection tool. Now to use the rest of these, you notice that they're currently grayed out, and that's because they do not apply once, they won't apply until we actually go into one of the editing modes. So let's go into the vertex, or let's go into the edge mode. And I'll go ahead and select this particular edge. And if you see here, it says isolated selection tool. Now I personally do not use this tool that often, but if you click it with something selected, it's gonna isolate this. It's gonna select all of those there. And that's pretty much how that works. I don't necessarily use that tool. If you find some use to it, go for it. Comment in the comment section, let me know if that's a tool that you use at all. The next tool we're going to take a look at is the loop selection tool. So if I select one of these edges here and I click on loop selection, it loops around this particular object. Now, same thing can be said if I select this edge, it should do it vertically. So if I select that, now if I want to do, say I select this one here at the same time and I hit that, it's now going to select that loop there. And we can continue to do this as long as we have an edge selected. All right. And that is the loop selection tool. The next thing we want to take a look at is the ring selection tool. So the ring selection tool is very similar to loop. The only difference is that if we select this here, instead of it going along a loop, it's going to go around this way. So if I select it, as you notice, it does that. And if I select this one, it's going to go just like that. Great. And I'll go ahead and deselect that. All right. So the next one is going to be the invert selection tool. So if we go to, say, the vertices and we want to select a couple of vertices like so, and say we don't want these, but we want to select the rest of them, we can go ahead and do that and do invert selection. And now we can manipulate just these particular vertices, but not, we're leaving out or excluding the five here. And you can kind of invert back and forth as needed. All right. So now let's take a look at the grow selection, and we have the shrink selection. So I'm going to select this particular vertice here. And if you hit the grow, it's going to grow. Every time you click, it's going to go to the most closest neighbor there. And you can actually manipulate the distance that it grows here in the bottom here, snapping the polygon. There's lots of different things here, but I don't typically always mess with this. But just knowing that this tool is going to allow you to grow that selection until you actually get to all the way around it, I'm sure. All right. Now, the same can be said for shrinking. So we can shrink it as well. Great. And you can select something like this. So say we just wanted to do something like that and you wanted to grow. It's going to grow like that. So that can be a pretty handy tool depending on what you're doing. Say you want to manipulate a vertice and then you grow it and then you want to manipulate it again and then you want to grow it again to keep gradually doing that. It can be very useful. All right, and that is all of your selection tools.